All right, so. We're going to do foil. Watch carefully now. On foil, you're going to draw your arrows. So you're going to say x times x, which is how much?
X squared.
X squared. Very good. What is this one times that one? Excellent. Any questions on the first level? Now we go to the second level. How much is this one times that one? Is it a plus or a minus?
Plus.
And how much is this one and that one?
-49.
Good. And now I combine these two. How much would this one and this one be?
Zero.
Zero. So this is your answer. This is called the difference of two squares. X plus 7, X minus 7. Is everybody clear on how to do number one? All right, next. And by the way, these are right off your test, right? All right, the next one is the quadratic equation. What is my A on this one? What is my B? And what is my C? Any questions on what I said or what I did? It's not 6, it's negative 6, and that will affect your answer. So it's x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all divided by 2a. Any questions on what I did so far? Is everybody clear? So now you put your numbers in there. Well, that's a negative 6, so that's going to give me two negatives. Negative 6, and then A, and then C, all divided by 2A. Any questions on what I did on the quadratic equation so far? Make sure you understand what I'm saying, all right? Because, you know, this is it after this year. You either pass that PERT test and move on, or you end up probably with another teacher trying to teach this to you. And you gotta move on. So a negative 6 times a negative 6 is a positive. A negative times a negative is a positive. Any questions so far? All right, so I get my calculator, and I press 36 plus 48. So 36 plus 48 equals. Hit shift. And square root. So all of this right here is going to be 9.165. So I'm going to have 6 plus 9.165 divided by 2, and I'm going to have minus. That's where I'm going to get my two answers. Is everybody clear so far? All right. So I take my calculator. I already got all of this in there, so I'm going to leave that in there, plus 6. So plus 6 equals divided by 2. One answer you should have is 7.6. Any questions on how I got 7.6? All right, now let's go to the negative. Clear it out. Press 9.165. Put a negative in front of it. Now put plus 6. Press equals divided by 2. Make sure you're doing this. I get a negative 1.6. Any questions on what I did or how I did it? Is everybody clear on this? You have to know how to do the quadratic equation. I mean, you guys tell me it's on there, so I guess it's on there. All right, let's go on. All right, next. This one right here, in order to do the quadratic equation, what do I need to do? Anybody? Thank you.
Square 6 times 8.
Well, no, because only the x is squared, not the 6. There's no parentheses there. Who can tell me how to work this problem? Go later on that note. Nobody can tell me? Well, you got to get it equal to 0. Okay, look up here. How do I get it equal to 0? Got to be equal to 0. So it's a plus, so you got to do a minus. So you're going to get 6x squared minus 54 equals 0. Any questions on what I did? What is my A now? What is my A? What is my B? Nope. You keep saying that, Sarah.
Yeah.
Is everybody clear that there is no B? The B is zero. Yes or no? All right. Memorize this. You must get it equal to zero. So, you're going to have x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c, all divided by 2 times a. There it is. Well, 0 is 0. Get rid of it. Get rid of that. A negative times a negative is a positive. Now, this is going to be a super big number. It's going to be 24 times 54. So clear your calculator. Press 24 times 54, press equals, hit shift, square root. All of this comes to 36. Nice, I like 36. So put plus or minus 36 over 12. Any questions on what I did so far? Now, well, 36 divided by 12 is 3, so that's one answer. A negative 36 divided by 12 is a negative 3. Alexis, will you stop, please? We're not in the cafeteria. We're in class. Is everybody clear on what I'm doing? Real simple. All right, let's recap. You had to get this one to the other side to get it equal to zero. You had to identify your A, B, and C correctly, and then you had to plug it in. Okay, is everybody clear on that? All right. On a new sheet of paper, try these two. Guys, I don't want coffee in my classroom. I don't want food in my classroom. Coffee goes on that table right there. You can bring water. I'm all right with that one.
What if you have coffee in the classroom? You can just keep it on the table.
You can keep it on the table. I don't want it in my classroom. If you don't follow my directions, I'm going to send an email home and let your parents deal with it. Work these two problems, please.
Does that have to be at the bottom?
Looks like, yeah. No, I think so. Put it in that little tray right there. Let me see what else I need to do. Okay, remember, if it's a minus, you got to move it up or you got to move it down, depending on what it is. I'm going to give you one more minute. All right, take a look. I want you to watch now. Okay, here we go. This one right here, you have more at the top or more at the bottom?
Bottom.
We got more at the bottom. How many more at the bottom?
Three.
That's your answer. If you don't put a 1, it's going to be wrong, okay? It's in the denominator. Now, Thomas, what is it you needed to know about that?
It's not that. It's like...
this one?
No. It's like there's just a 4 and like a 3 above it. Yeah, you do 4 times 4 times 4.
All right, hang on. I know what you're talking about now. Let's do this one since I got it. Look here. You see how this one is a minus? Move this one to the top. So I'm going to have G5, H4, and G to the 4th over H to the 13th. Is everybody clear so far? All right, now look here. How many G's do I have all together at the top?
Nine.
So put G9. Do I have more H's at the top or more H's at the bottom? How many more at the bottom? That's your answer. Is everybody clear on that? All right, now let's talk about the one that he's talking about. Now, I'm not quite sure which one it is, but I do know what type you're talking about. So everybody write this one down. Put 5 to the negative 3 times 5 to the 4th times 5 to the 10th. Is it like that?
Yeah, but it's just one of those.
I'm going to show you. Write this down. Is everybody with me so far? Okay, now watch. Do I have the same basis?
Yes.
Am I multiplying?
Yes.
So what do I do with my exponents?
I add
them up. That's all you do. So what's 10 plus 4? What's 14 minus 3? So your answer on your test is 5 to the 11th power. They don't want you to expand it out, okay? Now, is this not what we're talking about, Thomas? Be honest.
No. What I did with 5, like if it's a 3 over the 5, so it's 5 with the exponent of 3, would I do 5 times 5 times 5?
Yes. Yes. If it's 5 to the 3rd power, you're going to write 3 of these, just like you just said. So that's going to be 125. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All right. Anybody else? Let's look at number 31. Now, I didn't teach this one, okay, but I'm going to teach it to you right now. So right now, I want you to write down this equation right here. So put H equals negative 16t squared plus 28t plus 7. I think they give you one like this. So you guys are going to have to say yes or no or whatever. All right? Don't they give you one like this? No, you don't know? All right, look up here. Put x equals negative b over 2a. You must memorize that. That's your vertex. I tried to teach you the vertex. I know I did. All right, so look up here. What's my A?
Negative 16.
What's my B?
28.
And what's my C?
7.
Is everybody clear on that? All right, now watch. So you're going to have negative B over 2 times A. Write that down. Well, this is going to be a negative 28 over a negative what? 32?
Yeah.
And that becomes, what's a negative divided by negative? All right, clear your calculator. Take 28 divided by 32. So 28 divided by 32.
0.67.
All right, so put x equals 0.875. Sarah, you don't need that zero. Is everybody clear so far? Okay, this is called your axis of symmetry. All right, so draw a little graph. Watch. I'm going to show you what's going on. Here's one. So 0.8 is about right here. So draw an axis of symmetry at 0.8. All right. Now watch what we're going to do. Right here at point 8, that's going to be the highest point. Draw that graph as it looks like that. That ball is going to max out at 0.8 seconds. That's going to be the highest point, 0.8 seconds. Now they want you to find the height. That's your y. They want you to find your y. Here's my x. So you're going to plug this x into here to get the y. This is like your y. Okay, that h, the height, is really like your y. Okay, so right now I want you to take this and plug it in right here and square it, multiply. Plug it in right here and then add all that up right now. Do it right now. Plug it in and then I'm going to do it. Come on, plug it in. Substitute. You should know how to substitute.
Oh, 0.75.
Plug it in for your t. That's your time. That's your x. Need you to try. Put it in that bin right there. Substitute. I'm going to catch up with you. I just want you to do it. Yes. Wait till she comes back. All right, now look, I'm going to catch up. All right, so let's see, because some of you might have gotten stuck already. I don't know. So it's going to be y equals negative 16 times 0.875, I think it is, plus 28 times 0.875 plus 7. This is the height. Is everybody clear so far? Okay, let's square it. Clear your calculator. Now square that 0.875. So hit squared, which is right here, and then times negative 16. So put times 16, but put a negative in front of it. All right, I get, and you can check it, I get negative 12.25. That's what you should get as well. Is everybody clear on what I'm doing? Alexis, you're okay with this? All right, so take 28 times 0.875, press equals. I get 24.5 plus 7. So now I'm going to add 7. So plus 7, press equals, and then minus 12.25. The height is going to be 19, or y, it's going to be 19.25 feet. And x is 0.875, so seconds. At 0.875, less than a second, it's going to be the highest it's going to be. On that problem, you have to determine the vertex. The vertex is going to tell you everything you need to know. Will you slide in, please? Slide all the way in. All right, let me just recap what we did. First of all, do they give you one like this on the first test?
I didn't.
No? All right, maybe on the EOC, I don't know. But look up here. It's not hard. You can do it. Number one, you identify the A, the B, and the C. And then you got to memorize this formula right here. X equals negative b over 2a. You must memorize that, just like you must memorize the quadratic equation. This gives you the vertex. The vertex here is the highest point. You have your time, which is 0.875, and then you have your height, which was 19.25. This is your height. This is the time. And that's all there is to it. Seconds. So you have the time and the height.
I was wondering if you could show us how to do X or a problem.
Which one we're talking about?
It was 37. It's like 6x to the fifth power.
Yep, let's do 37 right now. Now that was on the practice test, right?
Yeah.
Okay, because I don't have it on the real test. Will you read it, please?
It's 6x to the fifth power y to the second.
And what about it?
How do you do that? Like, it's just all one thing. What do you do?
Sir, you need to leave. Go sit next door. Well, there's no directions on this. So, since there's no directions and it's not on the test, don't worry about it.
Okay.
You with me?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. All right, now let's move on. Grab your algebra nation book. Maybe in about 10 minutes. We're going to go to Section 7, Topic 4. Section 7. Topic 4.
Hey, Algebra Nation, welcome back. All right, so we talked about exponential functions, right? Which means you know naturally, we also got to be talking about graphs of exponential functions. Now, this is just part one.
I'm going to say it again. 7-4 is where you're going. 7-4. Chapter or section 7. Now, whoever started with Ben when I threw him out, he's trying to pass the first test. And I know one of you girls threw something his way. Because he retaliated. And that's not him to do that. So he just started it. Yeah, I don't think so. But I do know one thing. If he doesn't pass the PERT test and those of you messed him up today, then you're partly responsible. All right, where are we at? Page 191. So go to 191. And here we go.
All the fun we're about to have. Now let's review what we learned in the previous video about exponential functions. So consider an exponential function written in the form f of x is equal to a times b to the x. Okay, it would look like this, right? Now, which key feature of the exponential function does the a term represent? Remember, that was the y-intercept, right? And which key feature of the exponential function does the b term represent? Well, that was our common ratio, okay? If you want, we can actually go ahead and refer to the decimals link below the video, right? And it's going to show us this. So you can see here, f of x is equal to ab raised to the x. A is equal to 1, and b is equal to 2, right? So now,
so anybody
if you
know
move
where,
a around, you'll
so anybody
see
know where
changes,
it went?
The y-intercept changes, right?
No.
All right.
And if you move b around, what's going to happen? Well, it's going to stretch out some more, right? Or if you bring back b, or if you make b negative, notice how, or sorry, not negative, but you put b between 0 and 1.
It happens.
Notice how it starts to decrease, right? And at 1, it's flat, obviously, nothing's happening. But the bigger b gets, the more things are going to increase, right? Because that's the common ratio at which y is increasing, okay? Cool. So now, going back. Let's go ahead and do some practice. So consider the exponential equation y is equal to 2 raised to the x. Sketch the graph of the exponential equation. Okay, so let's see here.
All right.
You sketch the graph.
Sit down, relax. I think I got it, finally.
You had read that part right there, you said, Mr. Tubbs. Did you sign this for me after class?
I thought you were
with me. Let's try this again. Nope.
I don't have really white feet.
Hey, Algebra Nation, welcome back. All right, so we talked about exponential functions, right? Which means, you know, naturally, we also got to be talking about graphs of exponential functions. Now, this is just part one of all the fun we're about to have. Now, let's review what we learned in the previous video about exponential functions. So consider an exponential function written in the form f of x is equal to a times b to the x. Okay, it would look like this, right? Now, which key feature of the exponential function does the a term represent? Remember, that was the y-intercept, right? And which key feature of the exponential function does the b term represent? Well, that was our common ratio, okay? If you want, we can actually go ahead and refer to the decimals link below the video, right? And it's going to show us this. So you can see here, f of x is equal to ab raised to the x. A is equal to 1, and b is equal to 2, right? So now, if you move a around, you'll see what changes. The y-intercept changes, right? And if you move b around, what's going to happen? Well, it's going to stretch out some more, right? Or if you bring back b, or if you make b negative, notice how, or sorry, not negative, but you put b between 0 and 1, notice how it starts to decrease, right? And at 1, it's flat, obviously, nothing's happening. But the bigger b gets, the more things are going to increase, right? Because that's the common ratio at which y is increasing, okay? Cool. So now, going back, let's go ahead and do some practice. So consider the exponential equation y is equal to 2 raised to the x. Sketch the graph of the exponential equation. Okay, so let's see here. We sketch the graph of this exponential equation, y is equal to b to the x. So what do we know about it so far? We know our, this is going to be, our a is 1 times 2 to the x, right? Our a is 1, so our y-intercept is at 0, 1. All right? Now, where else would we have a point? Well, if we go ahead and plug in 1 for x, what are we going to get? We plug in 1 for x, we're going to get 2. So 1, 2 here is going to be 2 of our points. Okay, if you want, we can plug in something else. We can plug in 2 for x, we're going to get 4. All right? And it's going to, boom, rocket, take off like that. And then on the other side, remember, it's never going to touch the x-axis, right? It's going to get close, but never equal 0 for y. Okay. Now, is the graph increasing or decreasing? As we can see, it is increasing, right? From left to right, you can say increasing. Describe the end behavior of the graph. As x.
Now, look, I'm going to have to come around and check your books eventually, okay? So make sure you keep it up.
Increases from left to right. It looks like y is also increasing. As x increases, y increases. And as x decreases, well, from right to left, y is also decreasing, right? They have a good relationship. All right. Now, I want you to consider y is equal to 1/2 raised to the x, which, once again, our a is 1, right? When you don't see it, it's an understood 1, times 1/2 to the x. Now, sketch the graph of the exponential equation, okay? So here, that means our y-intercept is still at 1, okay, comma 0. Sorry, 0, comma 1, all right? So 0, comma 1 is our y-intercept because of our a. And here, what are we going to get? Well, if we plug in a 1, we're going to get 1/2, right? So 1, 1.
That one's decreasing.
Plug in a 2, we're going to get a quarter. So it looks like this time we're going the other way, right? If we plug in a negative 1, what are we going to get? We're going to get the reciprocal of that, which would be as 2, okay?
You kind of messed up on that, but it's 2.
So I'm approaching x from that angle and increasing that way, okay?
Let me make that clear on what he just did.
Okay, so let's see here. Y is equal.
He put a negative. I might have gone too far.
And on the other side, remember, it's never going to touch the a.
Did I go too far?
They have a good relationship. All right. Now, I want you to consider.
All right, look. He put a negative 1 right there. A negative 1 flips it. You got to remember that, okay? If it's a negative 1, it flips it. That's why the 1/2 became a 2. Watch and listen.
Y is equal to 1/2 raised to the x, which, once again, our a is 1, right? When you don't see it, it's an understood 1, times 1/2 to the x. Now, sketch the graph of the exponential equation, okay? So here, that means our y-intercept is still at 1, okay, comma 0. Sorry, 0, comma 1, All right, so 0 comma 1 is our y-intercept because of our a. And here, what are we going to get? Well, if we plug in a 1, we're going to get 1 half, right? So 1 comma 1 half. Plug in a 2, we're going to get a quarter. So it looks like this time we're going the other way, right? If we plug in a negative 1.
Now watch what he does. He's going to put a negative 1 right here, and it's going to flip it and make it a 2. Listen to what he says.
What are we going to get? We're going to get the reciprocal of that, which would be at 2. Okay?
And you can see he started to mark 3. So he's not doing too well on this, all right? But he's catching up with himself. He's correcting himself.
So I'm approaching x from that angle and increasing that way, okay? So is the graph increasing or decreasing? Well, this time it's going down from left to right, so it's decreasing. As x increases, what happens? It looks like as x increases, y is decreasing, right? Y decreases, and as x decreases from left to right, y is increasing. Okay, so they're doing the opposite of each other. Awesome. Now, you want to keep in mind that you can always write an exponential function such as g of x is equal to 3 raised to the x. In the form, g of x is equal to a times b to the x by writing the understood one in front of it, right? Which is what we just did. And the reason that's important is because it helps you find the y-intercept. Awesome. Now, consider the exponential equation y is equal to negative 2 raised to the x. So that means I could write it in the form negative 1 times 2 to the x, right? A times b to the x. So that helps me figure out my y-intercept is going to be where? In this case, it looks like my y-intercept is going to be at 0, comma, negative 1, right? So 0, comma, negative 1, that's going to be my y-intercept. 0, comma, negative 1, okay? So we flip the graph, essentially. Now, if I plug in any value here, if I plug in a 1 for x, what am I going to get? I'm going to get a negative 2, right? 1 for x gives me negative 2. If I plug in a 2 for x, what am I going to get? If I plug in a 2 for x, I'm going to get a negative 4. So 2 squared times the negative is going to be a negative 4. Okay? So it looks like, once again, oops, I connect those dots right there. We're coming up, getting close to the axis right there, right? So is the graph decreasing, or increasing, or decreasing? In this case, it looks like it is decreasing, right? And describe the end behavior. Well, as x increases, it looks like y is going to be decreasing. So y decreases. And as x decreases, y is going to be increasing. Okay? Now, moving on. I want you to consider the exponential equation, y is equal to negative 1 half to the x. So remember, in the form, negative 1 times 1 half to the x, okay? So can we sketch the graph of an exponential function here? Of course, right? So we're going to have negative 1, once again, comma 0 is our y-intercept. 1 half x, okay? So if I plug in a 1 here, I'm going to get a negative 1 half, right? Plug in a 1, I get a negative 1 half for x. If I plug in a negative 1, I'm going to get a negative 2. So I know my graph is going to go something like this, right? So this time, what is it doing? It is increasing. So this time it's increasing. The end behavior, as x increases, what's happening to y? Y decreases. Okay? And as x decreases, it looks like y will be increasing. Okay? Y increases. Awesome. Great job, guys. All right, now finally, we can create a nice, nifty little table here. Okay, and we're going to make a hypothesis about the relationship between the y-intercept, common ratio, and end behavior of a graph. Okay? This is going to help us relate everything. Now, if the y-intercept is positive, then are we going to be increasing or decreasing? The common ratio is greater than 1, then what happens? So the y-intercept is positive and the common ratio is greater than 1, that is going to be when we are increasing, right? When it's positive but we're between 0 and 1, then that's when it is decreasing. When we're negative in between 0 and 1, then we are increasing. And then if we're greater than 1, but we're negative, then we're going to be decreasing, okay? Now, once again, you can use decimals to help you with all these, okay? Then you move around the A and the B values, the common ratio and the y-intercept, then you'll start to see if it's increasing, decreasing, or not, okay? So that's very helpful. Now, what is the end behavior? As x increases, okay, with a positive y-intercept and an increasing graph, then y is also increasing, right? X increases, y increases. As x increases with a positive y-intercept and we're decreasing, then y is approaching 0, okay? So y is going to get closer to 0. When it's negative, y is still going to get closer to 0, right? When we're increasing. So we're going toward the x-axis, but we're never going to hit the x-axis, okay? And then finally, when it's negative and we're decreasing, then y is going to decrease as well. Towards negative infinity, that is. So y decreases, okay? And then finally, for the end behavior as x decreases, over here as x increases, okay, so when y increases, as x decreases, what's going to happen? Well, y is going to approach 0 once again, right? When we're looking at a positive y-intercept. Positive y-intercept here, as x increases, y approaches 0, but as x decreases, y is going to increase. Here, as x decreases, y is going to decrease as well. Decreases. And finally, y approaches 0 as x decreases down there. Okay? So this table is going to be very useful for you when you're looking at and interpreting the graphs of exponential function, or if you want to graph an exponential function. One last thing. Okay, and to finish off part one, if you get confused about end behavior, you can...
All right, before we play the rest of this, I had to email two parents just a little while ago, okay? You need to do what you're supposed to do in class, okay? And if you're not going to do it, then I need to get a little help from your parents. Sorry.
Sketch the graph of y is equal to a times b to the x, and the key feature is to see the end behavior. It's going to help you, all right? Or you can use decimals. It's up to you. That's it for this one. See you guys in the next one on part two, okay?
All right, we'll stop here.
Yeah, see, I got work. We might have skipped around according to what they tell me. Yeah.
Thank you.
Have a seat, gentlemen.